The pandemic is stifling venture capital deals, according to Fortune magazine, but it's boosting equity crowdfunding. That's when shares of a private company are offered to average investors instead of just the wealthy elite. Reporter Diane Mocha looks at how self-serve restaurant and bar Tapville is poised to go from 3 Chicago area locations to a national chain due to a growing appetite for raising money from the masses.
After getting a taste of the convenience of being able to pour your own beer and order your own food whenever you want, loyal customers keep coming back to Tapville since the restaurant opened in the Chicago suburbs 4 years ago. Many were so enthusiastic about the self-pour concept, they wanted to team up with founder and CEO Joe Toda.
We've had a lot of support from our customers and our loyalty club members on really asking if they could be part owners in our business, and a lot of interest in franchising.
When Joe was ready to seek funding to develop a franchise division, deep pocket investments began to dry up.
When you're trying to raise capital as an entrepreneur, it's knocking on doors, it's taking meetings with either venture capitalists or private equity firms. But with COVID, it's very hard to do that right now. Not a lot of people are taking meetings. So using a platform like Start Engine gives us the ability to reach a lot of people.
StartEngine.com is the top funding portal for equity crowdfunding, which became legal in 2016. Before that, only accredited investors with a net worth of more than $1 million had access to get shares of a private corporation. Now, craft beer lovers can get a slice of Tapville's future earning potential for less than the cost of 10 cases of brew.
$200? Absolutely, I'd consider it. Why not? I mean, I see what they do in Naperville. It's only a matter of time before they go national and make a big-time money, so absolutely.
Equity crowdfunding allows business owners to tap into a much wider group of investors than traditional ways of raising capital, and it gives employees and loyal customers a chance to own a small piece of a private company they love, like Tapville.
We've had over 250 inquiries for franchise requests, and we have a team right now that's handling those requests. And part of what we're doing to raise capital is to really build out our sales team, build out our marketing and our operations team to support those franchisees when they open their businesses.
More than 100 fans have already gobbled up a piece of Tapville's franchise division for $1 a share, looking to reap rewards each time a new Tapville location opens.
Our franchisees pay us a franchise fee. It's a one-time fee, and then we collect 5% of all their sales for the support that we provide.
Franchisees can get a full-service restaurant, a mobile trailer for outdoor events, or a kiosk suitable for airports and retail centers. Some malls are even paying entrepreneurs more than $100,000 to open a business like Tapville that attracts entertainment-seeking millennials and Gen Z.
We were the first mall in the Midwest at our Tapville Social Rosemont location to acquire a strolling liquor license, which means you can purchase a glass of beer or a glass of wine and walk around the mall while you shop with that beverage.
Joe says Tapville's secret sauce is its proprietary technology, which has cooked up unique ways to capitalize on the data of every customer who signs up for an electronic card necessary to access the taps, the menus, and the loyalty bonuses. Tapville tracks each customer's habits and offers personalized suggestions, just like StartEngine.com serves up bite-sized investments small enough for even an average Joe to swallow. Diane Mocha, Business First AM.
Our thanks to Diane for that report. Equity crowdfunding was created by President Obama's Jobs Act in 2012 as a way for small businesses to solicit investment money from any American adult, not just those with a high net worth. More Business First AM. Check us out on social media. We're on Facebook, YouTube, and Twitter. And go to businessfirstam.com for where to see our show on TV.